Hi, I'm Wade Wingler with the Indata Project at Easter Seals Crossroads in Indiana. Today we're going to talk about, you guessed it, the iPad. You know, everybody is excited about Apple's new product that's out there taking the world by storm. Well, of course we're interested in technology because we kind of get geeky about things like that, but we're really interested in how can the iPad be used to help people with disabilities be more independent. That's kind of what we're all about here. So we're going to spend some time in the future talking about the iPad and different things that it does, and as most people know, it is kind of touted as a laptop replacement or a larger size iPod Touch or does some similar things to an iPhone, and we'll spend some time on that. But one of the programs we want to talk about today was designed to work on the iPod Touch in the iPad. It's called iPrompts, and it's a really cool program that does a few things to help people who have issues with memory, cognitive issues, to be more productive throughout their day. So for example, one of the things it does is called schedules. And it has a list of things that you can create to help remind you how to do things throughout the day. So for example, the one I have here is called getting ready in the morning. So we have eat your breakfast, getting dressed, brushing your hair, brushing your teeth, and it has both pictures as well as text to help somebody know what they should do next. You can import these schedules from selected ones that are already available. You can create your own. You can import pictures into this and make them however you want. So you can have a series of different schedules to remind somebody how to be more independent throughout the day. There's also a thing here called countdown, so that if you told somebody, hey, you need to spend at least 2 minutes on washing your hands, you can go in and set a countdown so that somebody who's doing that activity could have a picture to remind them to wash their hands, and it counts down for 2 minutes and gives you a visual representation here of how much time you have left so that you know when you've spent enough time washing your hands or brushing your teeth or those kind of things. You can also use it for basic choices. Now here I've got set up a yes and no screen where somebody can indicate with their hand or visually whether they're answering yes or no to a question. You can also add pictures to make that a little more intuitive for folks who might not be literate and have the ability to make choices like that. And then there's a library application here that lets you choose from a lot of different pictures that are already available to help you set up schedules or your countdown timer or your choices. So there's a lot of things in here that have common household objects, different activities of daily living, things that everybody wants to be able to do to indicate what they want to be able to go out in the community and spend their day and do those kind of a thing. So this is just one of the programs on the iPad that we're going to be talking about. In the future, we may spend some time talking about some voice recognition, some communication systems, and the other everyday kind of things that you can do with an iPad. So if you have questions about the iPad or want to know how it might be useful for you, let us know. Help us choose what those future tech tips might look like. So that's your tech tip for this week. I'm Wade Wingler with the Indata Project in Indiana.